Hello, and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. Happy Canada Day! It's July 1st, so that is Canada Day, if you weren't aware. Fun fact, this is lipstick. I can't wear face paint. So I'm gonna do a quick cartoony little Canadiana fan art type piece, and I'm gonna talk a little bit about the history of the 1st of July in this country and why it's a little bit different here in Newfoundland.
Since this is Canada Day, I figured I should do an art piece that's representative of Canada. Our national animal is the beaver, and of course there's a maple leaf on our flag, so I came up with this cute little cartoon beaver with a maple leaf in the background. Excuse any awkward points if I missed spots where I was interacting with the iPad. That's what I'm reaching for at the top of the frame. I did have a photo of a beaver up so I could make sure the shapes were right, even though it's a cartoony beaver, and then I had a photo of a maple leaf up so I could make sure I had the angles of the points right. You probably don't know this about me, but I've had a couple different majors in university over the years. Before I moved out here to Newfoundland, I was a Bachelor of Arts student at Kwantlen out in BC. I majored in history and minored in psychology, and to be more specific, my focus was on 20th century wartime history, with special attention to the Canadian and UK presence in both world wars. I ended up with this focus partly because I loved Canadian history topics in high school, so I looked for that in university, and partly because my favorite professors I found through those courses had these focuses. My favorite professor, Dr. Tor Fron Nielsen, is a Danish immigrant who co-authored the textbooks that Kwantlen's first-year Canadian history courses use, but his true passion is British history in the modern era. Another of my favorite professors was Dr. Alex Popovich, coincidentally also an immigrant from Serbia, and he taught a bit more of a variety of European history courses. He also taught a Russian history course that I quite enjoyed. I didn't always enjoy his reading choices, but I'm glad I read them. He believed that you couldn't truly understand the history you were studying until you read fiction written in that time by the people you were studying. My favorite of his selections was Erasmus's In Praise of Folly. But I digress, I'm rambling. I studied history in university, particularly Canadian and wartime history. This means I was well aware of the history and significance of July 1st in Newfoundland long before I moved to Newfoundland. For those who don't know, yes, July 1st is more than just Canada Day in Newfoundland. For Canadians in general, July 1st is our national day. It's the anniversary of the proclamation of the Queen that the British North American Act had been signed and was in effect. The BNA Act was actually signed on March 29th, but the Queen's Declaration of the Dominion of Canada came on July 1st. This joined the provinces of Canada West and Canada East, Ontario and Quebec respectively, Nova Scotia, and New Brunswick into a semi-independent union. Canada actually did not receive total autonomy until Queen Elizabeth II gave royal assent to the Constitution Act of 1982, though we've been mostly autonomous since the Statute of Westminster in 1931. If you know anything about Canada's provinces and territories, you'll notice that Confederation came into effect with significantly fewer provinces than it has now. A significant part of what is currently Canada's prairies and northern territories were British territories known as Rupert's Land and the Northwestern Territory. Much of that land became part of Canada in 1870 with the creation of the province of Manitoba and the Canadian Territory of Northwest Territories. British Columbia, my home province, joined next in 1871 with the province that the Canadian Pacific Railway would join them to the rest of Confederation in no time. That actually ended up taking another decade. Prince Edward Island joined in 1873, and the Yukon Territory was carved off of the Northwest Territories in 1898. The remainder of the prior Northwestern Territory land in the prairies was granted provincial status and divided into Alberta and Saskatchewan in 1905. All of this was prior to the World Wars, but Canada currently has two more member provinces and territories. Nunavut, our third northern territory, was carved off of the Northwest Territories in 1999. I was 11. Newfoundland and Labrador, my current home, used to be a semi-independent dominion in the British Commonwealth known as the Dominion of Newfoundland. It was given over to Canada in 1949 when it was guaranteed a ferry link to the mainland. We do have one, for the record, two in fact, but locals are still salty about the fact that PEI got Confederation Bridge in 1997 and there's still no plan for a drivable link out to the rock. But pay close attention to that date, March 31st, 1949, 5 years after the end of World War II. Newfoundland, being part of the British Empire for both World Wars, was automatically at war when Britain was at war. As such, Newfoundland sent troops over to Europe for both World Wars. World War I was a turning point in terms of the way wars were fought in Europe. Trench warfare was new. It was common practice at this time to train and send what was known as buddy brigades, where troops were trained and deployed in groups based on where they came from. You trained and served with your neighbors and friends. This meant if a brigade or regiment was wiped out, some poor town or region back home was devastated with the loss of a significant number of their working and marriageable aged men. The Dominion of Newfoundland, being a small population, sent a single regiment overseas. The 1st Newfoundland Regiment, sometimes referred to as the Blue Puttees for their original uniform colors, were deployed in France. During the First Battle of the Somme, on the first day of the battle, July 1st, 1916, the 1st Newfoundland Regiment was virtually wiped out in a quick defeat at Beaumont-Hamel. 780 men received orders to go forward at 8:45 a.m. Half an hour later, only 110 men remained alive. And of that, only 68 men reported for roll call the following morning. This was the first major conflict experienced by the Dominion of Newfoundland, and their first and only regiment was all but destroyed. In Newfoundland, July 1st has since been an anniversary of mourning, marking the devastating loss of a huge portion of an entire generation's young men. On March 31st, 1949, the Dominion of Newfoundland became the 10th province of Canada, and as such acquired the national holiday, the celebration of Canada Day, July 1st, Newfoundland's Memorial Day. So my fellow Canadians and my friends abroad, while you celebrate our country's Confederation today and enjoy your extra day off work, remember the 1st Newfoundland Regiment, and take a moment of silence for the hundreds of young men who lost their lives at Beaumont-Hamel. If you're a fellow Newfoundlander, consider visiting one of our own local Beaumont-Hamel memorial monuments. My favorite is the bronze caribou statue in Bowering Park. If you happen to be in the right area of France to access it, consider taking a guided tour of Canada's national memorial sites at Beaumont-Hamel or Vimy Ridge, where you can hear more about Canada's participation in the wars from my fellow Canadian students of history. Thank you so much for watching to the end and listening. If you got this far, let me know in the comments down below. I'll be back twice more this week, tomorrow and Thursday. See you then.